Dan Tricks here, and I'm doing some more tricks from Carl College Volume 3, and I think it's going to make your world a little bit more interesting. Okay, so last week we covered some tricks from Volume 2, and now this week I'm going through Volume 3. Volume 2, Volume 3. So this one goes through false display counts, the riffle shuffle techniques, multiple shift, barrow shuffle, double lift, display counts, terminology, all sorts of things. I don't know what happened to this, but it got ripped. Now, I've had this a few years, I've actually forgotten how that happened. And there's a great chapter here, chapter 37, colour changes. The first one, which is the side slip colour change, the slap change, the wave change, the Houdini colour change, the flip-flop change, and finally, the fadeaway card change. And I think you'll agree, a nice few, so a selection of colour changes there, and they're not the hardest ones to perform, very visual. As you can see, the snow is here, freezing cold out there, and not only that, my neighbour stole a pair of my socks. And I've seen them on his washing line. Well, I was going to go and confront him, but, I've got cold feet. Okay, let's get into this first trick now. It's a nice little effect. Hope you enjoy it. See you after. Okay, now for this effect, the spectators can, in fact, shuffle the cards as much as they wish. So they mix the cards up. Now, I'm going to take out two cards. And the two cards I'm going to take out are in fact the Ten of Clubs and the Ten of Hearts. Ten of Clubs and the Ten of Hearts. There you go. Now, the reason being why we have these two cards, the Ten of Clubs and the Ten of Hearts, is because the top two cards are in fact the Ten of Spades, which we'll place in front of the Ten of Clubs, and of course the Ten of Diamonds, which we'll place in front of the Ten of Hearts. Now I take a pile like so on top of each card. Now watch, these two cards being the magic wands, I'll wave and the two cards will rise up to the top of each pile. A miracle. Now I'll do that again. I'll take these two cards from here, the Ten of Diamonds and the Ten of Spades. Two cards, watch carefully, Ten of Spades and of course the Ten of Diamonds. We'll take the Ten of Spades over here, Ten of Diamonds goes in front of this card here. Cut the cards, pile on top of each one. Now we'll use these as the magic wands and the cards will rise up, but this time they'll switch. And now the Ten of Diamonds is on top of this pile and the Ten of Spades on top of there. And that is a goddamn miracle. And that is called Rise and Switch. And that's on page 590. It goes down really well with the lay audience, so make sure you check that one out. So let's get into the second effect. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you after the trick. Cheers. Okay, this is a nice effect you can do in a bar or a restaurant. It requires a pack of cards or one empty glass, and a spectator can select any card they wish. In this case, it is the Queen of Clubs. Now they can sign it, doesn't matter. The Queen of Clubs goes into the deck, like so we'll lose the card. Let's give them a shuffle, like so. Now, we have over here this empty glass and these pack of cards. I'm going to take this glass and in fact rub it on top of the cards, like so, very slowly. And one card will now appear inside the glass. And it is in fact their card, the selection, the Queen of Clubs. That's called The Card in the Glass. And that's on page 731. Let's get into the third one. I hope you enjoy this. I think this is really, really nice. I've done this a few times and I tried to look for some footage of me actually performing it to some people because I have performed this out in the real world a few times, but I couldn't find the footage. So I'm filming it for you now, doing it to myself, but it's still just as good. Enjoy. Okay, would you like to see a trick?
Yeah.
Would you like to see one?
Yeah.
Okay. Would you have a pack of cards? Would you take a card for me, please, sir? You have the Five of Clubs. Would you pick one? And you have the Nine of Clubs. So we have the Five of Clubs and the Nine of Clubs. We'll place the Five of Clubs into the deck. and we'll lose the 5 of clubs, like so. We'll take the 9 of clubs, that also gets lost into the deck, like that, making sure the cards are well and truly lost. Now what we're going to do is take this piece of silk from here, watch the silk as I place the silk over the deck of cards, like so, and all I'm going to do is reach under the silk and see if I can select one of the cards, which is in fact, what was your card, sir?
9 of clubs.
The 9 of clubs, which is the first selection. Now, let's see if I can find the next one. Let's find it, and got it here. And your card is a 5 of clubs. The 5 of clubs. And that is also the second selection. But now that we've found the 2 cards, we don't need the rest of the deck. It has vanished. Gone. Thank you, thank you. And that is called The Vanishing Deck, and that's on page 679. So be sure, check that one out. That is a beauty of a trick, The Vanishing Deck. So let's get into this final effect now. Also in the Paul Harris Art of Astonishment book. Not the same one, but it's similar. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you after. It's a goodie. Okay, now this effect uses 8 cards. And what we have is, in fact, 4 sevens and 4 kings. What we're going to do is take these 8 cards from here, and I'm going to take the kings, 1, 2, 3, 4 kings, and place them to one side over here. That leaves us with the 7s. Now I'm going to take the first 7, watch this 7 from here. I'm just going to give it a little wave like so, and it becomes a king. That's the first king. Now watch again, that leaves us with 1, 2, 3 sevens. Watch this 7 here as a little snap of the card, and it becomes a king. Place that king over here, that leaves us with 1, 2 sevens. Watch the next 7 become a king, and then of course the last one becomes another king, giving us 4 kings. But all I've got to do is press that reset button, and now all 4 kings have become 7s again, and leaving us with over here we have the 4 kings. And that is a trick using 8 cards. There you have it. That's called Set Reset Plus. So many different versions of that, but that's the version out of this. And that's on page 616. Paul Harris does one in Art of Astonishment. If you've got the Art of Astonishment books, check that out. That's really, really nice. So I really hope you've enjoyed these effects. Smash that like button, leave a comment, let me know which one you liked or which one you didn't like. Make sure you subscribe, press the bell so you don't miss any of my
videos.
Because you don't want to be missing them. Well, there might be something in it for you. So thank you for your time. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your support. I really, really appreciate it. And I'll be seeing you in the next one. More from this fantastic book. See you next week.